कॉम्प्रेसिबल फ्लो। So in the today's class, we will study the expressions for the velocity of sound wave or pressure wave in a fluid in terms of bulk modulus, second one isothermal process, and third one is for the adiabatic process. So first we will study the velocity of sound in terms of bulk modulus. So already in the first module we have studied bulk modulus. It is denoted by the symbol K, so which is defined as ratio of increase in pressure divided by change in volume. The change in volume is given by decrease in volume to the original volume, where this bulk modulus K is given by dP, that is nothing but increase in pressure divided by dV by V, where dV is the decrease in volume, where V is the original volume of the fluid. Because negative sign is used here, as the pressure increases, there will be a decrease in the volume. We already know that mass of the fluid is constant. It is mass is given by density into volume is constant, whereas density into V is constant. So differentiating this above equation, here this density and volume both are variables. So let us differentiate this equation rho. Differentiation of V will be dV plus V into d rho equals to 0. So therefore rho into dV is equals to minus V into d rho. This equation I will write in this form, that is minus, this equation I will take here to the left hand side, minus dV by V equals to d rho divided by rho. So now I have calculated the value of this. Now minus dV by V is equals to d rho divided by rho. So let me substitute this value in this above equation. Value in the above equation, that is K is equals to dP divided by d rho divided by rho. Substituted the value here, minus dV by V is replaced by d rho by rho. So therefore K is equals to rho into dP divided by d rho. Or we can write this equation in this form also, dP by d rho is equals to K divided by rho. Let me call this equation as equation 8. We know that already we have proved this, C is equals to root of dP divided by d rho. We have proved it now. Whereas now dP divided by d rho is nothing but K divided by rho, that is bulk modulus divided by density. So this dP divided by d rho is replaced by root of K divided by rho. Therefore this C, that is velocity of sound wave, is given by root of K divided by rho. Let me call this equation as equation 9, which gives the velocity of sound wave in terms of the bulk modulus and the density. So this is equation is applicable for both liquids and the gases. So this is the final expression which gives the velocity of sound waves in terms of this bulk modulus K and the density rho of the fluid. So next, now we'll velocity of sound wave for the isothermal process. So isothermal process, how we'll write this, pressure divided by density is equals to constant, or this equation we can write in this form. So PV is equals to constant, where V is the specific volume. Specific volume, it is the reciprocal of the density. So P divided by rho is equals to constant, or we can write this expression in this form also, P into rho to the power minus 1 is equals to constant. That means this equation I have taken it to the numerator. So now let us differentiate this above equation. where this pressure P and density both are variables for isothermal process. So let me differentiate this P. I have kept constant first P into differentiation of this rho to the power minus 1. So that will be minus 1 into rho to the power minus 1 minus 1. That will be minus 2 into d rho plus rho to the power minus 1 into dP is equals to 0. Let me call this equation as equation 10. So now dividing equation 10, entire equation 10 by rho to the power minus 1. Now we will get this minus 1 into P, this will be minus P into rho to the power minus 1. If I will divide it by rho to the power minus 1, this will be rho to the power minus 1 into d rho plus rho to the power minus 1. This rho to the power minus 1 gets cancelled. So my equation will be dP equal to 0. Whereas this dP is equals to P. dP is equals to P divided by rho into d rho. This I have taken it to the numerator side. So therefore this dP by d rho is equals to P divided by rho. dP divided by d rho is equals to P divided by rho. Whereas P divided by rho I can write in terms of R into T, where P divided by rho is given by RT, that is equation of state equation. So C is equals to, already we know that C is equals to root of dP divided by d rho, whereas this dP divided by d rho is replaced by P divided by rho, because already we have proved it here, where P divided by rho is nothing but RT. So this P divided by rho is replaced by RT, so square root remains as it is. So this equation, let me call this equation as equation 10. So this is the velocity of sound for isothermal. Study velocity of sound wave for adiabatic process. So for adiabatic process, already we know this equation P divided by rho to the power k equals to constant, or we can write this equation in this form also, P into rho to the power minus k is equals to constant. This equation I have taken it to the numerator side. So differentiating this above equation, we will get now again P constant. So differentiation of rho to the power minus k. So this will be minus k into rho to the power minus k minus 1 into d rho plus rho to the power minus k into dP. This is dP equal to 0. So again dividing, let me call this equation as equation 12. So if we will divide the entire equation 12 by rho to the power minus k, we get P into minus k as it is. So rho to the power minus k, rho to the power minus k gets cancels. My equation will remain rho to the power minus 1 into d rho plus dP. Rho to the power minus k, rho to the power minus k gets cancels. dP equal to 0. So therefore dP is equals to, that this becomes P into k divided by rho into d rho. So therefore dP by d rho is equals to P into k divided by rho. So already we know that P divided by rho is equals to RT. So k remains as it is. So k into RT. So already we know that C is equals to root of dP divided by d rho, whereas dP divided by d rho is replaced by P into k divided by rho, where P divided by rho is nothing but RT. So therefore square root remains as it is. PK divided by rho is replaced by K remains as it is. P divided by rho is RT. That means C is equals to square root of KRT. So this is the final expression for calculating the velocity of sound wave for adiabatic process. Let me call this equation as equation 13. Next part we will study Mach number. So what do you mean by Mach number? So this Mach number, it is defined as the square root of inertia force of the flowing fluid, the elastic force. So this Mach number, it is denoted by the symbol capital M. So where M is equals to square root of inertia force, whereas this inertia force is given by the formula, that is density into A into V square. So what do we mean by inertia force? So inertia force, it is the fluid's resistance to the change of state of the motion, which is given by the formula density into area into velocity square. Whereas elastic force is given by the formula where K is bulk modulus of elasticity into A. So here A and A gets cancels. So my equation remains square root of V square divided by this rho by K. I have written the equation in this form, that is K divided by rho form. So where M is equals to, I will remove square root only for this term. So square root of V square will be V. And for denominator, I will keep this K by rho in the square root form only. So C is equals to K divided by rho is equals to C. Already we have proved it now here, where K divided by rho is given by C, where it is now M is equals to V divided by C, because already we have proved it. C is equals to root of K divided by rho. So where M mass, that is Mach number, is given by the formula V divided by C, where V is velocity of the body moving in the fluid, and where C is velocity of the sound wave in the fluid, where V is the velocity of the body which is moving in the fluid, where C is the velocity of sound in the fluid. That means Mach number is given by the formula V divided by C. So next we will see types of flows which are classified on the basis of the Mach number. The flow is defined as three types of flows, that is subsonic flow, second one is sonic flow, and third one is the supersonic flow. So first we will study, what do you mean by subsonic flow? Flow is said to be subsonic flow if the Mach number is less than 1. If the value of the Mach number is less than 1, then that type of flow we are going to call it as the subsonic flow, which means the velocity of the flow is less than the velocity of the sound wave. That means velocity of the body which is moving in a fluid, its value is less than the velocity of the sound wave. Next we will study sonic flow. A flow is said to be sonic flow if the Mach number is equals to 1, that means M is equals to 1, which means the velocity of the body which is moving in the fluid, that is V, that will be equals to the velocity of the sound wave C. Then that type of flow, it is called as the sonic flow. Third one is the supersonic flow. Flow is said to be supersonic flow if the Mach number, that is M, is greater than 1. That means velocity of the flow V is greater than the velocity of the sound wave C. Then that type of flow, it is called as the supersonic flow. So we have studied three different types of flows which depends on the basis of the Mach number.